Okay.
It's been a part of me since this all started. It's cold. Dead. But it still sees. I can see everything. The void. Like looking under the waves and into the sea.
This one was obsessed like all the rest. What did he find out?
Oh, sick.
combination to his safe might have something to do with those strange symbols. Is that the mark of the outsider? This one was obsessed like all the rest. What did he find out?
The topography of the void is dependent upon reality to supply the base material for it to mirror. However, there is one place that has no referent in our world. Though I know the void sees into our hearts, my fellows call it the ritual hold. Some say it is a cradle. Others say a tomb. The outside.
There were subtitles. Oh my god!
He himself resides there. To even approach the gate to that place is sacrilege. And even then, the void itself keeps it shut to living eyes. Truly, the ritual hold exists outside of time itself. It would be as futile as it is forbidden to enter. These are thoughts for another time. My research into this ancient alphabet continues. Some remnants of their phonemic qualities are preserved in our oldest writings. The language possesses an unusual amount of diphthongs, reliant on distinction in tone and pitch to convey meaning. These symbols, I know the very nature of the void runs through them, but is it a dead language, or the language of the dead? Perhaps that could be the title of my next monograph.
Well, 3 games in and I learned that I can turn on the subtitles. Well, that's great. Because for some idiotic reason, they're put in the fucking audio. There. Is that it? I can actually kill them. Okay, that makes some things much easier.
The outsider been drowning at the heart of the void.
No, no. Let's first go get the... Oh, screw this, fuck's sake. No wait, 962.
The mark is the outsider's name. And this says only spirits in the void can read it.